from The Sound of Music in the 60s to being the first actor to play a live-action Spider-Man in the 70s. Nicholas Hammond has an endless list of credits to his name, and you can get the chance to meet him this weekend. He joins us now live, and a very good morning to you.
Good morning to you, Angela. It's really nice to see you again.
Now, you've been to a few Comic-Cons before, and this is where people get the chance to meet you face-to-face this weekend. What can fans expect?
Well, I've did one in Hollywood and I did one in the UK. I just thought, as you say, with so much bad news in the world today, overseas and now here with the weather, when I was asked to do this, I thought it would be really a fun thing to do and an opportunity to say thank you to all those people who all through the years have
I think we have a little problem with our signal there. No doubt the weather is playing havoc. We'll just try to see if we can get Nicholas Hammond back for our interview. We're just going to try to redial. What I might show you in the meantime was you may have seen Spider-Man No Way Home. It's the biggest box office hit of the year. And I interviewed Tom Holland and actually asked him whether he had seen Nicholas Hammond playing the original Spider-Man. Let's take a look.
But what about the amazing Spider-Man himself, Nicholas Hammond?
I like his costume. It looks much comfier than mine.
it's got a bit of wriggle room in it.
Yeah, it's got a bit more stretch to it. I think his is made of cotton and mine's made of spandex.
So, as you can see, the costumes did look vastly different. I'm just going to check in and see. And, yes, I think, Nicholas, we do have you back. Can you confirm that the suit was as stretchy and comfortable as Tom Holland make out and you could eat all the donuts?
No, mine wasn't. Mine was not comfortable at all. And it was, you know, we filmed a lot in LA and we filmed in Hong Kong, and those are hot places. And a hot suit when you're running all day in it is not the best. But listen, I now regret deeply that I didn't keep one of them, because they've become such collector's items. And I wish I had. I wish I'd held on to a Spidey suit. But you never know. I mean, down at Supernova this Saturday in Melbourne, somebody might turn up with one. I've seen a couple of them appear over the years.
When you took on the role of Spider-Man in the 70s, there wasn't this proliferation of superhero movies. I guess Adam West had been Batman, but you were a serious actor. What were your thoughts when you first got offered it, and how did you make the decision to become the webbed wonder? Oh, I think the weather is determined to cut into our interview this morning, which is such a shame. Well, we've got the original Spider-Man in our midst. We will try to get him back one more time. It's worth just looking through some of these clips from the 70s version of The Amazing Spider-Man, just for the cars, as you know. That is particularly my interest sometimes.
Quite amazing, isn't it, Ange? No Way Home. It is Paul, my six-year-old's favourite movie ever. He's dying to get back and see it again. That it all came from such humble beginnings.
I know. But it has always been a fascination for all, not only little kids, but big kids as well. The Amazing Spider-Man was one of the top rating shows on US television when it came out. And you look at some of the ways they made Nicholas look like he's flying. Just incredible.
Special effects are awesome.
Aren't they? Are they
Nicholas,
great?
Are you back?
I hoped I'm back. I think the spider sense has been interfering with the signal here a little bit.
Indeed. So what did you make when you took on the role, first of all, and what was it like doing some of the stunts? How did they make you soar through the air?
Well, I mean, to be honest, a lot of the difficult stuff, the stunt-wise, was done by my double. I don't think the insurance company was going to let me jump off the top of the Empire State Building, but I did the stuff on the top of buildings and a couple of the swings, and it was huge fun. It was huge fun. I remember on day one, I had to do something where I jumped off a building and I landed into the back of a garbage truck on top of a pile of stinking garbage. And I remember looking up at the director and saying, "Are you sure Clark Gable started this way? Because it seemed like a very ignoble way of starting a series."
Now, what are your thoughts on the latest Spider-Man movie? There were a bunch of Peter Parkers there, but yours was missing.
Well, I would have loved to have been in it. I mean, it got reported that I was really upset that I hadn't been invited. That wasn't true. I just thought for the fans, it would have been a huge kick for them to see all of the original Peter Parkers on screen together. And who knows, someday it may happen, but there was certainly a large outpouring of people who online who said they would have liked to have seen that. So you never know. You never know. Next time they make a movie, if they want me to, you know, pop in or be a waiter in the back of a scene, I'm happy to do it.
Well, given the success, you would imagine that could very well be on the cards. Now, you have a bit of an interesting story of how your role as Spider-Man led you to playing Sam Wanamaker in the Quentin Tarantino hit Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
That's right.
Just from a couple of years ago. Tell us about that.
That's right. Well, Quentin is a big fan of my series, which I didn't realize, but somebody told me he's running the pilot to your series as a feature film at his cinema in Hollywood. And I thought, well, that's great, because I'm a big fan of his. And so I got a message sent to him saying, you know, look, if you ever want to meet and just talk about Spider-Man and talk about Peter Parker, let me know. And he answered back and said, I'd love to meet. And I had no idea he was making Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. But we went and we talked. And at the end of the talk, he asked me if I had heard of Sam Wanamaker, and I had. And he said, well, you know, take a look at this DVD. It's a Western that he shot called Lancer. And I went home and I looked at the DVD, and the next day they called up and asked me to play Sam Wanamaker. So it was a huge treat for me. It was like a little wonderful Christmas present all those years later after playing Peter Parker.
Just incredible. And Leonardo DiCaprio brought his mum to set to meet you. I'm not sure she was a Spider-Man fan so much as maybe a bit more of a Sound of Music fan.
She was a big Sound of Music fan, a very big Sound of Music fan. And Mrs. DiCaprio is a lovely woman. I saw her when I was in Cannes for the opening, and I saw her in Hollywood for the opening. Yeah, she's a big, big fan. She's German, so I guess it makes sense that, you know, it's a film close to her heart. But I did say to her, you know, your son did, you know, he did Titanic, and it was kind of like, yeah, but not Sound of Music.
I love that. That puts
Which
it all.
Was funny.
That puts it all in some perspective. You as Frederick in Sound of the Music, in Leonardo DiCaprio's mum's eyes,
right,
tops him in Titanic. That is as it should be. Nicholas, you've been in so many things, more than 40 movies, 170 TV series. What's on your bucket list? Mm. What role are you itching to play?
Well, it looks like I've done four films for Bruce Beresford, and I really love working with Bruce. And there's another one in the pipeline, COVID willing, that I'd love to do. Of course, I'd love to work with Quentin again. He's just a genius and the kindest, nicest, most supportive director you could ever hope to work with. So I guess if I have to say, work-wise, I would love to work with either of those two directors. I think Bruce Beresford and Quentin Tarantino are both superb directors, and I've loved working with both of them. So I hope I get a chance to work with them both again. I know I'm one of a long list of actors that wants to work with them, but I hope they think of me.
I think they do think of you a lot, as we do. It's so great to see you. And if you would like to see Nicholas in the flesh this Saturday, he'll be jetting into Melbourne. You can grab tickets at moshtix.com.au. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Always a pleasure, Angela. Hope to see you soon in the flesh.